Hello and welcome back to week 3 video 2 of the SAS Bootcamp. In this video, we are going to get into a little more advanced stuff about loops. In the previous video, we talked about really simple loops with a do loop, with a counter variable. In this video, we are going to talk about a do loop, we are going to talk about a do while loop and a do until loop. And we are going to really start to leverage the power of these loops and all of the things that they can do, right? Let me begin by writing an example. I'm on SAS Studio here. Let's say I want to create a data set called loop one. I am not going to write a set statement in this particular example because I'm going to create this data set without any pre-existing data set, right? I'm going to create this fresh data set and I'm going to tell SAS what to put in this data set. Now, the goal of us creating this data set is we want to create a data set that shows randomly generated scores and grades for everybody that is taking the SAS bootcamp, right? Let's say there are 15 people taking the SAS bootcamp. We want to create a fake data set which contains scores of this bootcamp for all 15 people, and then we want to give them all grades from A, B, C, D, E, and F, right? So let me begin by using a do loop. I'm going to say do I equals 1 to 15. I'm going to write my end statement. Whenever I write my do statement, I first write my end and then I finish off with a run, because one of the things that you will forget to do very often is you'll write the do, but you will forget to write the end. And then when you compile your state, when you compile your SAS code and run it, SAS will throw you an error saying one do loop was not closed. That's the technical error message you get. It will tell you that a do loop was not closed. So if you just write the end before you start writing the sentences in between do and end, you are less likely to make that error. Anyway, so let's say we do this, right? I say, I'm going to take this video step by step. So let's say we do a do I equals 1 through 15 for each of the 15 people in our data set. What do you think will happen if I run this code? Just this code. The do loop is creating a new variable I, which it is looping from 1 through 15, and it is looping it 15 times, but I'm not going to put any statements in between my do and end. Let's see what happens. This is my output data set, right? It contains one column and one row, and I equals 16 in this data set because it ran it 15 times. And after incrementing it one more time, I was equal to 16, at which point the loop terminated and the new data set was created. This is good, but we actually want to do something more meaningful. So let me throw in an output statement here, right? We have not seen output. We have not encountered output statement in the SAS bootcamp so far all by itself like that. So let's see what it does, and then we can talk about how it works. Right? There is no if then for this output statement, it's just output. When I run this one, I now get a data set with 15 rows and just one column. The one column is my column I, the variable that I had just created, and it goes from 1 through 15 and it gives me 15 rows. Why did it do that? Well, that's because when you ran this do loop with the output statement, each time the loop ran, remember the loop runs 15 times, right? Because I, the counter variable, is going from 1 to 15. But each time the loop ran, it basically had the output statement within it. And the output statement told SAS, go ahead and add this row of data to the output data set. So loop one, our output data set, was added, one row was added to that output data set for each time this loop ran. So when the first time the loop ran, I was equal to 1. And that was outputted right here, which is row 1, where I equals 1. And then I was incremented to 2, and the loop started executing again. When the loop started executing again, it came across another output statement, and then it output that second row into our loop 1 data set, where I was equal to 2. And then I got incremented again, and it encountered another output statement. So for each output statement, it basically added a row to our output data set. And each time it was adding that row, the value of I happened to be different because I gets incremented every time the loop is executed, right? So towards the end of this short little program, I've already created 15 rows in my data set with the variable I that is equal to 15. Now, if I had just called I ID or student number, then I would have had an ID variable for my data set, right? Which is really good. And that gets us started in creating this data set of fake scores for this SAS bootcamp. Let us now try to leverage the value of a do loop. The first thing I want to do is actually I'm going to format my code to look a certain way so it's easier to read. But going back to the earlier topic, the first thing I want to do to leverage the power of this do loop is I want to use that variable I, which is the counter variable, to do some fun things. Let's say I want to create a new variable y, which is I raised to the power of 2. In SAS, if you want to say raised to the power of 2, you just add 2 asterisks next to each other. That is similar to many other statistical software out there. So if I run this one, now my output data set has 15 rows and 2 columns, the I column, which we saw earlier, which is like that ID, and then y, which is basically square of the I variable. So 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, so on and so forth. Now I've got an extra variable in my data set. Now let's go ahead and create scores for each of these 15 people in the data set. I want to do this randomly because I don't have any way to assign scores right now. This is a fake data set. So I'm going to say score equals, and I'm going to use SAS's random generator function. The random generator function, which you've not been exposed to so far, is actually called RAND or RAND. The RAND function takes in several forms. The form that we are going to use is a very simple simple way to use it. I'm going to say that. What this is saying is I want SAS to generate random numbers in a new column called score so that for every loop, the score will have a certain random value. And how does it generate the random value? Well, I'm giving SAS certain parameters for generating it. I'm telling SAS that the random value has to be chosen from a normal or a Gaussian distribution, which is that inverted U distribution that most of you that have taken any introductory math or statistical classes should be familiar with. So it should have an normal or a Gaussian distribution with a mean value of 80 and a standard deviation of 10. That's what these two numbers tell SAS. Why am I setting 80 and 10? I could have picked any number I wanted. I just want my average student to at least be a B student in this class. So the mean score I'm assigning is 80, standard deviation is 10. And let's see what these numbers look like. We should have another column now called score, and there it is. And this is randomly generated, right? Randomly generated with a mean of 80, standard deviation of 10. So if you actually do the mean procedure on SAS, which we will come to in a few weeks, you will get that number when you actually run that on this variable. But we've got numbers here all the way from 94.6 to I see a 71.5, 76.3, 74. So we've got a good variety of numbers. Now, the one thing this score function does not do is it does not tell SAS that, hey, as you're generating these random numbers, make sure you don't generate anything over 100% or anything less than a 0%, which in theory, in a normal distribution, they are possible. They are unlikely, but they're absolutely possible. So first thing I want to do is I want to say if score is greater than 100, then just set it to 100. So my data set looks more meaningful. It looks like real scores. And if score is less than 0, then just set score to 0 because I don't want anybody getting negative percentages in my class. Hopefully this is not such a bad class that we have negative percentages, right? So I'm going to set max and min for my score variable. Now, there are ways to do this within that random function operator, but I'm not going to show that right now. You're welcome to explore those things on your own. But for now, we set a maximum and a minimum on our class scores using simple if-then statements. Next, I want to assign a grade for each individual based on the score that was randomly generated for them. And this grade can be anywhere from A through F. I'm not going to type this. I had typed this out earlier. I'm going to just paste it in here. And you can see what this looks like. So what this is saying is if score is less than 70, then grade is an F. If score is between 80 and 70 and 80, then give them a C. 80 and 90 is a B. Greater than 90 is an A. Right. So what we've done right now is create a fake data set with 15 rows where we have an ID variable, which tells me the ID of the student, a variable called Y, which is meaningless for now, and then a randomly generated variable called score that tells you what was the score of each individual. You'll see there are actually some hundreds in here, some 63, some 64. If you're wondering why the numbers here are different from the last time we opened the data set, every time you run this code, SAS generates new random numbers. And the numbers are new every single time you generate it. If you don't want it to be new every single time you generate it, there are some seed functions you can utilize. But again, that goes beyond the scope of this video. and this bootcamp. You can learn that on your own later or get in touch with me and we can talk about it. The final variable we created is that grade variable, which assigned a B for an 87, C for 71, F when they were less than 70, A when they were above 90. Right? So this worked exactly as I wanted. And you are beginning to see here the absolute power of that do loop. Right? With that do loop, we started with nothing and we've now created a data set with 15 students, and I can create 500 students if I wanted to, right? We can create a data set now with 500 rows where we have 500 people, all of their scores and their grades. And you can see how quickly this do loop can do so much for you using just a few lines of code. Now, this is a good start to a do loop, but let's go on and add a little more complexities, because all we've done so far is we've looped the data set 15 times. We've looped SAS 15 times for each row, added an output statement, which adds that row to that output data set, and then a bunch of statements. And depending on what you're working on, those statements can be anything, right? But we haven't done anything much more complex than that. So let's go on and add a few more things. Now, I told you that the do loop increments the counter variable according to the range that is provided in that syntax. In this case, that is 1 to 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the value of I, and the loop keeps executing over and over again until I hits that upper range. But what if you don't want the loop to work that way? What if you want, because I here is incrementing by a value of 1 every single time, right? It's going from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4. What if you wanted a different number? Well, you can do that using the by function. Right? The by function basically changes the amount that I is incremented by. So previously I was incremented by 1. If I write that by 0.5, I gets incremented by 0.5 instead of 1. Let's run it and look at our data set. I'll check my log to be certain. Log looks good. Okay, look at the data set now. Now we have 29 columns in the data set, and I went from 1 to 1.5, to 2, to 2.5, to 3, to 3.5, so on and so forth, right? And y is still the square of I, and score is still randomly generated, so nothing changed there. What we did here is we changed how much I increments by every single time the loop is run. This is super neat, and right? And this can accomplish a lot of things. Now, there are ways to go even further. Both the loops that we've seen so far, without the by 0.5 option and with it, are both do loops. But there are ways to actually get the loop to stop executing based on other criteria rather than the upper end of the counter variable within the do option, right? Because what is happening here is that the loop keeps running until this maximum number 15 is reached. What if you wanted to have some other criteria for that, for when the loop should stop running? Well, that's when you can use things like the while operator and give another condition for when the loop should stop running. Let's say I want the loop to stop running when I want the loop to run while y is less than 25. So when, as long as this condition, which you have to list that in parentheses after the while statement, you have to list it in parentheses. As long as this is true, the loop will run, right? Because we have a while there, just like in regular English. Once this condition is not true anymore, the loop will stop executing and it will go to the end statement no matter the value of I. So whether I is 1 or whether I is 10 or 2 or 15, the loop will stop executing as soon as this function becomes false. Let's run it and we'll see what this actually provides us. Checking my log, looks good. Okay, output. So you see now what is happening is that Y is, which is the square of I, basically starts growing really quickly. And once it hits 25, the loop stops. When the loop stops, I is only equal to 5, when actually in our do loop, we've written that the counter variable I can go from 1 all the way up to 15, but the loop stopped a long time before it hit 15 because the value Y hit 25, and that was the condition that we added in our do loop. While y is less than 25, that last row here hit that condition. This became not true once y was 25 for that last row, at which point it went ahead and went to end, and then the run, and then the data set was created and we saw the output, right? Now there are ways to tweak that. If you don't want to use the while operator, you can use the until operator, which is the exact opposite of while. What the until operator says is that the loop will keep executing until a certain condition is met. As soon as that condition is met, the loop will terminate. So in this case, I'm going to change this to greater than or equal to. And what this will do is that as soon as y becomes greater than or equal to 25, the loop will terminate. Earlier, what we did was that the loop was running while or as long as y was less than 25. Right? As long as y was then 25, the do while loop kept running. But as soon as y becomes equal to 25, the do until loop stops running. So let me run this, see if it makes sense. Check my log here, okay. And then my output data set, and there you go. It's the same exact output, except in this case, we use the until operator instead of the while operator. The score and the random numbers for score and grade, none of that has changed. So that should not bother us at all. But this will show you that the do loop with while or until can be really leveraged to do some very, very powerful things with a very few lines of code.